Hello and welcome to this exam question video. We're looking at 16.3 today on this AQA GCSE paper, and it's asking us to define rotation. Now, before we go into rotation and its definition and use in sport, I quickly want to clarify the difference between rotation and circumduction, because they're quite easy to get round the wrong way, and if you describe one opposed to the other in either situation, then it might be an easy 2 marks that you're missing out on. So to start with, what is rotation? Well, it's to do with the axes. Now, an axis is an imaginary line or an imaginary pole around which our body is able to rotate, much like a wheel turns on the axes that runs through it perpendicular to the direction of the wheel. So if the wheel is standing upright, then obviously the perpendicular axis that runs through it would be the axle of the car, axle axis. Similarly, in gymnastics, which we could actually use here in a sporty example, the axes would be the bar, and the gymnast who is holding onto it with their hands is rotating around that axis perpendicular to it. So how do we define rotation? It's a circular movement around an axis. Now, this could be the whole body, such as in gymnastics on the bar or doing a somersault or a backflip or a cartwheel. If we were to turn that axis that goes through the front and out the back of a performer, the cartwheel is then turning in that circular motion around that imaginary axis. The other way that we can define rotation is where both ends of a limb are rotating around the axis that runs through it. So if, for example, you were to stand with your hands straight down by your sides and your palms facing forward in anatomical position, and you were to rotate your whole arm with your elbow locked out, your thumb would turn from pointing outwards to pointing inwards. This would be rotation, because the whole limb is rotating around that axis that runs through the limb at the same rate and speed. Circumduction, on the other hand, is when one end or one point of a limb stays fixed, and then the other end moves in a circular motion. So we end up with a shape that, if you were to trace the movement, looks like a circle-based pyramid or a cone shape, where the point at the top was the fixed part of the limb, i.e. the shoulder joint, and the circle base of that cone was drawn out by the hand as it circumducted around. So if you were, for example, in backstroke, in swimming, if you were to complete a backstroke by moving that arm around in a backward circle and you didn't turn your hand, so you kept your palm facing the same way, then that would be circumduction. But you could use that same example in this definition example for rotation. If in backstroke, as the performer reaches for the next part of the water, they are rotating their hand. So if it's sticking out like this, rotation is turning on itself. The whole limb from top to bottom rotates along the same axes. Circumduction is when the limb stays fixed, but it actually makes a circle at the end of the bone. Okay? Now, rotation is on that single axis. Circumduction, on the other hand, is actually moving in all three different planes. It's moving across different axes through different planes in order to actually generate that movement. So it's a combination of flexion, extension, abduction, adduction. So how would you define rotation? It's a circular movement of a limb or body around an axis. When would we see that in sport? We would see it in gymnastics during a somersault, or a gymnast on the beams going all the way round, or it could be in cricket or swimming when the whole of the arm turns on itself, for example, in a spin bowl in the cricket, or in football, it could be when a person completes a side foot trap and they go from standing with their feet facing forwards and they turn their toes to point outwards so that the inside face of the foot is there to control the ball. And that's that, the difference between rotation and circumduction in sport. Hope it helped, and I'll see you again in the next one. Bye for now.